And every word he said was clever, and every parable I remember, Matthew has recorded, and Luke I think has more yet. And I can't remember if I tried what I heard about in junior high, but some things taught by Jesus Christ remain. Refusing to die. So bye bye, Mr. Terrible Guy. Got my lessons through the lessons taught by Evans Messiah. The good old days of seeking wisdom divine. Sit and listen to the Terrible Guy. Listen to the Terrible Guy. Like to tell the song. Cause a true believer's rock is slow when the sea gets wasted by the boat. Just fancy and flop and they'll grow. Well, I know the storms will come against, so don't build your mansions in the sand. He won't pick off the fruit that fig tree induced.
I've also heard riots are breaking out against the council.
Run a man.
Our job? To restore order. We were up against a sophisticated operation, and we learned the finest minds in criminal protection. I present my colleagues, Sherlock Holmes and Cable Assistant Watson, the ever-lovely Jesse Drew, and of course, Inspector Clouseau.
You feel things after you, and you don't know what to do. No crimes are committed, you have no clue who did it. We know the evidence is somewhere, you gotta call us, we'll go there. No case of water is praying for us, most of all, you can trust us. Gotta find those clues, gotta find those clues. Just gotta find those clues. Gotta find those clues, gotta find those clues. Just gotta find those clues. Gotta find those clues, gotta find those clues. Just gotta find those clues. Gotta find those clues, gotta find those clues. Just gotta find those clues.
There once was a woman named who had the sin that she would always do
On every Tuesday at 11:15, she would admire the whole wedding present.
The item was a necklace with shining gold, and later with 10 silver coins of gold.
Ooh, shiny!
One day, however, her habit was turned upside down. Coin number 10 was not there to be found.
Oh my, whatever am I to do?
Said the woman named
Lou. The coin is so special to me, you see. Oh, where can it be? I'll search high, I'll search low. I'll even check under the narrator's towel.
I assure you, it's not there.
I'm still going to search everywhere.
Anyways, she searched under the bridge, over the fridge, through the castle moat, and on the king's boat, in the back of the shelves, and outside the cottages of... elves. She looked here, there, and everywhere. Whoa. In the air and on the ground.
Yet the coin was nowhere to be found.
Oh my, whatever am I to do? Whether treasures, I have no clue. I search under the bridge and over the fridge, through the castle moat and on the king's boat, in the back of the shelves and outside the cottages of elves. I looked here, I looked there, I looked everywhere. Where it is, I don't know. The only place I haven't looked is under the narrator's toe.
Okay, anyways. She called her friends to tell them the good news. When they had come, she exclaimed,
"Rejoice with me, for I found what was lost."
Then the teacher babbled on about us having joy in the presence of one sinner being found by God, or something like.
And she found what was lost. I had a feeling this was important, but I couldn't say why. Thank you, ma'am. You've been most helpful.
You're welcome. Have a good Saturday.
Ma'am, I...
Friday, but today is Saturday.
Right. Have a good day, ma'am.
Thank you. I've seen those people before.
That girl I hooked on many 554s. And him over there. He's gotten caught with his hand in the cookie jar way too many times. All these people are the highlights of the lowlifes in our city. And I've never seen them this happy or clean.
Everything's been different since the teacher came to visit. Some of the members of this crowd have been completely turned around.
What did the teacher say that affected them this way?
One man asked what he needed to do to inherit eternal life. And the teacher responded, as quoted in the book of Deuteronomy, "You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your strength, and all your mind. And you must love your neighbor as yourself."
I see. But who is the man's neighbor?
That's precisely what the crowd asked. So he responded,
with a parable.
I'll mention my dear friend. And this is the story he told. There once was a man strolling along the beach, enjoying the beautiful blue sky and the rolling waves.
Man, this would be a totally sweet spot for vacation lodge.
Then, without warning, a thief ran up to him, knocked him over the head with a coconut, and stole his wallet.
Like you said, if those other guys weren't home, there's no Now, I need to keep the business running smoothly, and I can't allow people to hold off on paying back what they owe.
Oh, darling, I have a piece of